the car around. It's like trying to push a shopping trolley with a dodgy wheel.
And this isn't over yet. Sure, maybe for the race leader, but how about the fight for second? Fraser side by side with Borg. Borg gets him. Vanner again from downtown. And on the outside, oh, big one. Peter Vodanovich up and over in a big way. And the Kiwi takes a wild ride through the chase. He missed that one badly. And at the checkered flag, it's Luke King winning a dramatic and exciting race in the Toyota 86 Racing Series. They'll scrap all the way to the checkers. How much more could possibly have happened in that race? Championship leader out, no points. Second in the championship, struggling. Gibbons still trying to get that car home. And hopefully Peter Vodanovich is okay down there in the chase. He's a young racer from New Zealand. And he went for a monster ride then. No small accidents go through the chase, and that was a big one. Some good drives off the back of the field. Still Robotham moving forward, up 10 spots this time. So great drive, make that 9 actually. And that was a wild moment down at the chase. Lots to dissect after that one. Wow, look how far he went as well.
And that was a wild moment, Chad. So we can see the medical car in the background making their way. We've been told that Peter Vodanovic is moving, which is good to hear. Medical team are on site. So let's cut through the replays. Luke King, he's out of there. No problem. Lockie Gibbons comes in really hot. Did a great job to try and hold on to it, but that contact with the concrete wall on the run down to the dipper would ultimately do too much damage to the left rear of his car, dislodging the tow link. Now let's have a look at this. Borg on the inside of Fraser. We know Fraser's wounded. Have a look at that right front wheel of Fraser's. It's a lot of damage. Vanner down the inside, but look at Vodanovic in the background. So much momentum. He's missed his brake marker by the look of that. And with so much extra speed versus everybody else, clipping the back of somebody and sending him into a rollover. Shades of Fabian Coulthard, although a little bit further down the road.
Wow, and in slow motion as well. This 18-year-old from Auckland.
So sparks from the roof as it slides along the bitumen, and then when it gets to the dirt, trips itself up.
This could be one of the most spectacular shots of the weekend as this car does what it's designed to do, protect the driver in a situation just like this. And the good news in an incident like this one, Andy, it dissipates energy, it sheds its skin, it pops glass, it may even throw wheels off, but the important thing is the driver is kept safe inside. And the technology and safety that is paramount in these cars, doing exactly what it's designed to do. Particularly the roll cages and the crew from Neil Bates Motorsport who build these cars so safe. That is a big one. Peter with his hands up around his helmet, hanging on. Former racer in the SsangYong series in New Zealand, stepping up through the Toyota 86 rank. And another driver from Norwell. All three drivers from Paul Morris's academy involved then at the chase, all scrapping for every last spot. And that is an incredible image at Bathurst.
And great to hear that Peter was moving around from within that car, having been in a rollover down at Phillip Island many years ago. They do look spectacular, but thankfully, as you just well pointed out there, Chad, the energy doesn't get dispersed in a hurry. And as violent as it looks, it doesn't actually feel too bad from within the car. So comes to a nice rest in the sand trap, slowed the car down, got rid of the energy in a very gentle and slow motion. Worst thing you'll ever see is an incident like Paul Radisic's on the opposite side of the road.